so good. I'm a Grundig TK1400 reel-to-reel portable tape recorder. I take 5-inch reels. I have mono 4-track capability, but I can't record anything. Why not? Continue watching this video, and you'll find out. Someone was mean to me!
I'm happy in spite of the fact that this machine can never be restored. Why? Because I use Happiness DSPP Subliminal Message Program to boost and maintain my 9 levels of core happiness. You can too. Don't let life get you down. Happiness DSPP is a real program, and it does work. Learn more at www.clydesight.com or Google Happiness DSPP today. We're looking at the Grundig TK1400 5-inch reel-to-reel 4-track mono tape recorder. I purchased this unit from eBay, and unfortunately, it is not a fully functioning unit because somebody got into the machine and removed some of the circuits. Let's take a quick look at the tour of the outside. There's a volume control, a tone control, there's sliders. There is a meter, a VU meter here, and a special recording switch that I'll discuss in a moment, plus the function control. There are two switches. This is for tracks 1 and 2, this is for tracks 3 and 4, which I will demonstrate in a moment. The machine is a single speed 3¾-inch machine, and it takes reels up to 5 inches in diameter. The inputs and outputs are on the side, and they're very, very simple. There is a DIN socket here for a microphone or a auxiliary patch cord, depending on which pins you use. There's a power jack here and a speaker output here. The power jack is one of the unique Grundig jacks, so I'm jumping the battery terminals in order to power this. So let's take a look at the 4-track capabilities of the machine. I pre-recorded this on a stereo machine because this will not record.
This is the left channel, the left channel, the left channel, the right channel. This is the right channel, the right channel. 1 and 2, 3 and 4, 3 and 4. Left channel, channel.
So you can hear that if you switch these two buttons, you go from the left to the right channel. I believe that because this machine had the 4-track capability, they kept it at 3¾ inches per second, giving you the same amount of tape use that you would get if you had the 1 7/8 option. And I'm going to show you the record function using a Philips microphone. It has two positions. It says Auto SP and Auto Music. I believe this machine had an AUTOVOX circuit at one time, and I think it's been removed. And what you would normally do is you would simply pick music or speech, press the button down, and now, if I turn this up, you can hear that it's coming out of the speaker, which it should not be doing, and the meter is not registering anything. And I'm going to rewind and you'll hear there is no recording.
Left channel, 1 and 2.
So you see it made no recording at all. That's because the circuit that is required for that is missing. I believe that when you set it for speech, pushed it down, interlocked it, it worked as an AUTOVOX similar to my Granada in my video Restoring Granada. When it was set to music, there's a switch inside that defeats the AUTOVOX but still allows the recording feature. So without that circuit, this machine will never record again. This is the problem when you buy machines at yard sales or eBay or any place where they've been used. You do not know how well they've been taken care of. It's a handsome machine. The clear plastic cover here has been marred. Somebody put something on it and marred it. And the inside of it is quite handsome as well. It's a pity that it is not able to record. We'll very quickly take a look at the rewind and fast forward functions. For rewind, you simply take this knob and turn it down. To go to fast forward, you have to go through pause, start, and then fast forward. So pause, start, another pause, and then finally you're at fast forward. Then when you push it to pause again, and then it could play, and then pause, and then stop. It's a unique control system.
Oh, I don't feel so good. I'm a Grundig TK1400 reel-to-reel portable tape recorder.